Hi, thanks for clicking on this video. My name is Jesper, and in this video I will talk about x-rays. I will try to keep it simple, and I will talk about how the x-rays are produced, how we obtain the image on the film, and how it penetrates the tissues, and why the different tissues will appear in different ways on image. Let's get started.
X-rays are electromagnetic waves. Here we can see a representation of the electromagnetic wave spectrum, and we can see that their wavelengths are shorter than UV light but longer than gamma waves. Their energy level, however, is higher than UV lights but lower than gamma rays.
So to summarize, we can see that relative to the wavelength spectrum, X-rays are photons with high energy but short wavelengths. They are produced when high energy accelerated electrons with a high enough velocity collide on a type of solid matter. Now this whole process is made possible within a tube, a so-called X-ray vacuum tube, which is usually made out of some sort of glass, and it creates a vacuum so that it prevents essentially any interference, so that the electrons, which can freely flow from the cathode quickly into their target, which is the anode. So how does it take place? Well, we have a cathode, which you can see here, which is the filament within the X-ray tube that is which acts as our source of electrons. Now the cathode is a metal surface and it's connected to an electrical current, so it can be heated up. This is necessary because electrons are normally stably staying within the metal of the cathode, since in metal electrons are attracted to the positive nuclei of the metal atoms. Now, when we heat the cathode up to a very hot temperature, then it can release electrons by this new energy that we add, and this process we refer to as thermionic emission. Now within the tube, the electrons needs to be accelerated, and the way that this happens is by increasing the voltage difference between the cathode and the anode. When this is done, the electrons will travel towards the positively charged anode, and then they will collide with the anode and then release this excess energy in the form of heat and X-rays. Now, when the X-rays then travel through the different tissues of the body, they can either penetrate the tissue, be absorbed by the tissue, or be scattered. What process will take place vary according to the different tissues' density, thickness, and atomic number. Bones, for example, have a high atomic number, so they contain high amounts of calcium, so many of the X-rays photons are absorbed and do not travel further. Now, this is also the reason lead can be used to block X-rays and is often used in X-ray protection. On the other side of the tissue, a detector is located, which captures the X-rays and their radiation. A classical X-ray film contains silver halides, which reacts with the X-ray photons to form images which are darker at the parts where the radiation was higher, which is why bones and contrast media shows up as very pale parts on the image, since they absorb more of the photons, so which then will reduce the radiation that is received on the film or the detector. Now, in this way, we are able to create a 2D image of our body. However, if we want to be able to obtain a 3D image, one of the best options is with a CT scan, which I will talk about in my next video. That's it. Thanks for watching the whole video. Hopefully things were explained to you in a way that you understood it. And in the next video, I will talk about how computer tomography works. So stick around for that.